Students of Academics and Competitive Exams of English. Today in this lecture 1, part 1 English version lecture, we are going to study complex sentence. Complex sentence that is based on adverb clause. Students, before we start studying adverb clause, let's know what is an adverb. Adverb is a word that says something about a verb, an adjective or an adverb. Students, if it has more than one word, it is called adverbial phrase. Now, if it is a part of a sentence, it has its subject and predicate, it's called adverb clause. Now, finally, we can define it as an adverb clause is a subordinate clause which functions as an adverb in the sentence and qualifies a verb, an adjective or an adverb given in the principal clause. Let's study all this in this example. If it rains, we shall not play. If it rains is an adverb clause and we shall not play is a principal clause. And if it rains can also be said subordinate clause. If it rain qualifies or modifies the verb play, shall not play. In this way, it is called adverb clause. Adverb clause can be classified according to what they show as follows. And they show time, place, condition, purpose, result, reason, contrast, comparison, and manner. Students, let's begin with the point number 1, adverb clause of time. The conjunctions used in this adverb clause of time are as long as, so long as, after, before, as soon as, no sooner than, while, as, till, until, just as, etc. Now, let's take the example as long as. As long as shows duration. Suppose something happens in continuous form, you use as long as. Sometimes it is not written in continuous sentence, even then you use as long as. Suppose you are sitting somewhere and during your sitting you will study. In the sense, we use as long as you are here, study well. After this, the conjunction after is used in the middle of the sentence and you can use it in the beginning of the sentence. The sentence is, he went to Europe after he had saved sufficient money. After he had saved sufficient money can be written in the beginning and you can write first part, he went to Europe later. In this way, your sentence will become, after he had saved money, comma, he went to Europe. If you use conjunction in the beginning, you put comma in the mid. And if you use this conjunction in the mid, you don't need to use any comma between these two parts of clauses. Let's begin with before, another conjunction of adverb clause. She has cooked food before she goes to school. She has cooked food can be written after, before she goes to school. Then our sentence will be capital, before she goes to school, comma, she has cooked food. Student, the thing that we have to clarify, we should understand clearly is that if we use conjunction after, we use perfect sentence in the second part. If we use before, we use perfect tense in the first part. You can also say after is the first word of the clause related to head and before is the first word related to indefinite tense. So if you write indefinite tense in the beginning, in this way before will be the first word of the sentence. If you write past perfect, present perfect in the beginning, then after will be the first word of the sentence and you will put comma between these two clauses. This sentence can be written after he had saved sufficient money. It means after will be connected as a first word with the perfect tense. Now let's begin with as soon as. In as soon as shows quick action. When one action happens, one action is performed just after another action within a fraction, then we use as soon as. As soon as means quickly. As soon as she sees the lizard, she gets frightened. Students, you can also write it. She gets frightened as soon as she sees the lizard. Now let's take another example. No sooner do they ring than somebody laughs. Students, if you use no sooner in the beginning, you use helping verb just with no sooner before your subject. And it's compulsion to use than then in the mid of the sentence. So students, if you have a past indefinite tense, no sooner did she come, no sooner does he come, then you use it may be in perfect, it may be in past indefinite, it may be in present indefinite, you use helping verb in the beginning. And you write then in the mid of the sentence and then next part of the sentence. In this way, students, you came to know the definition of adverb and adverb, you have come to know adverb clause. And students, in other parts, part 1, part 2, part 3, we will continue this complex sentence, and I hope you will come to know in future. So please keep on watching Oracy Classes of English and subscribe this channel so that you may complete this complex sentence and you be updated before anybody. Please like, share, comment, and again I would like to say subscribe our channel Oracy Classes of English Language and comment in comment box if you have any problem. Thanks.